Blackstone Audio presents Honor Before Glory, the epic World War II story of the Japanese-American GIs who rescued the Lost Battalion, by Scott McGaugh, read by Traber Burns. To Marjorie, who shows me every day how to fight life's biggest battles with spirit and style. Preface. Every day is Veterans Day for me. In 2004, I became the founding marketing director of the USS Midway Museum. I work with and welcome veterans of all stripes aboard the museum in San Diego every day, including World War II veterans. More than 1.3 million visitors a year join them to walk in their shoes for a few hours and experience service and sacrifice for America aboard an aircraft carrier. I see World War II veterans approach a teenage U.S. Marine who graduated from boot camp earlier in the day to thank the youngster for his service. I listen to Vietnam veterans sharing their prisoner of war POW stories with visitors from around the world. I see Afghanistan veterans roll aboard in their wheelchairs. You would pass most of these veterans in the grocery store and have no inkling how much they have sacrificed for America. I've discovered how so many of these otherwise ordinary Americans were remarkably brave under horrific circumstances, how they somehow maintained their humanity when surrounded by barbarism. Honoring the legacy of those who served and sacrificed for our nation has become my passion. Their legacy must be preserved for future generations. Honor Before Glory is my seventh book and was the most difficult to write. The story begins a few months following the attack on Pearl Harbor, when America incarcerated more than 100,000 Japanese Americans living in Seattle, Los Angeles, San Diego, and elsewhere only because of their ethnicity. Remarkably, a year later, thousands of them volunteered for combat in a segregated army. Some served with the 442nd Regimental Combat Team, RCT, in Europe, and others reported to the Military Intelligence Service in the Pacific. This is the true story of just one of the remarkable feats of the 442nd, the rescue of a battalion surrounded by Germans on an obscure mountain ridge near the German border for nearly a week. It is the story of how the 442nd succeeded where other battalions had failed. The 442nd not only reached 211 surrounded men, but by the end of the war also became the most decorated regiment of its size in World War II. Honor Before Glory chronicles the best of America and, in some ways, the worst of the nation. I hope readers will pause and reflect on an American spirit that spawns incredible bravery and one that allows discrimination and hatred born of fear and revenge. This book is largely based on previously unpublished and rarely seen oral histories recorded by the men who were there. It builds on other chronicles of the 442nd, with new insights from those who often fell bleeding on a remote mountain ridge in eastern France in World War II. To be sure, this is not the big story of World War II in Europe. It is a small story, a single rescue mission, that tells a much larger story. And that is the story of the millions of Americans who fought and sacrificed in Europe, each man's sacrifice for a larger cause. It is the story of Japanese-American citizens' devotion to duty and their acceptance of sacrifice for a country that for a time considered them enemies. It also sheds light on a post-war debate that has simmered for decades. Some came to question the use of the Japanese-Americans' combat regiment, questioning whether their commanding general treated them as dispensable cannon fodder or relied on them as one of the Army's bravest and most accomplished regiments. Nearly all of the participants have passed away or are in their 90s. More than 100 of their oral histories recorded in the last decade of their lives are a treasure trove, as are obscure Army documents. Spending nearly a week on the ridge where the rescue mission took place and working with two French residents of the Vosges Mountains who are experts on the mission, were invaluable. There was no substitute for personally examining the length of the ridge where the rescue mission took place, or for sitting in the foxholes dug by 442nd soldiers more than 70 years ago, to look down and see both American and German machine gun cartridges in the same foxhole was chilling. This is the story of young Japanese-American men in a remote forest, in their foxholes, at the aid stations, on suicide charges, and in the command posts. Their legacy was one of unparalleled service and sacrifice, one man at a time, for a greater cause.
Go Forward by Lauren Edia,
West Torrance High School, California. One suitcase, each family, all else left behind. Dignity, freedom, liberty, were those left too? Trapped, alienated, segregated, confined, stripped from their red, white, and blue. Is this the American way? Citizen or alien, friend or foe? Should I fight or should I stay? Are you a yes-yes or a no-no? Yet the great sea crashing against the shores, grasping, clasping the land of both of homes, engulfed in sweat, sorrow, and war, treated like monsters in this world we roam. Our freedom and families we defend don't take back a single stroke, never give in until the final end. We all stand strong, go for broke. I, a Japanese American, stand free today thanks to the sacrifice of those before, the courage of every soldier, every child, every Nikkei who plowed through the demands of war. Go, go, go forward, go forward, fight for our freedom, liberty, our pride. Never take another step backward. Strength in every leap, every march, every stride.
Prologue.
He reeked of cigarette smoke, wet wool, fear, gunpowder, rubber, and sweat. So did the others in the primitive foxholes and trenches they had dug nearby. No one had showered in days. To Matsuji Mutt Sakumoto, everything stunk on the morning of October 30, 1944, in the Vosges Mountains of eastern France. For nearly 100 hours, he had battled German machine gunners, snipers, and artillery in near constant rain, almost cold enough to become snow. For 5 days.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.